Since its discovery as the cause of poliomyelitis, poliovirus has been the subject of intensive characterization. The structure of poliovirus has now been determined at near atomic resolution by X-ray crystallographic methods, giving a clear picture of the architecture of the virion and allowing several of the biological properties of the virus to be interpreted in the context of its three-dimensional structure. The first view of the virus shows the solvent-accessible surface of the particle. This picture is analogous to an electron micrograph, except that the resolution is higher, revealing that the particle has a great deal of surface relief. Here, we see a cross-section of the virus particle with a molecule of trypsin and an antibody molecule shown for size comparison. The protein shell of the virus extends outward as far as 165 angstroms in radius, but several deep valleys in the surface of the particle bring the outer surface in as far as 137 angstroms. The protein shell is thin, averaging 30 to 40 angstroms in thickness. The inner surface of the protein shell is also highly irregular, extending in as far as 100 angstroms radius and outward as far as 118 angstroms. The inner core of the particle is filled with the viral RNA. The RNA, however, is transparent in the X-ray experiments since it lacks the icosahedral symmetry of the protein cult. A molecule of tRNA is shown here for scale. The poliovirus capsid consists of 60 copies each of four coat proteins, VP1, VP2, VP3, and VP4. Throughout this presentation, VP1 is shown in blue, VP2 in yellow, VP3 in red, and VP4 in green. VP4 is totally internal and is therefore not seen in this view. The particle has the symmetry of the regular solid, the icosahedron, which is shown here in white outline. Thus, the particle has fivefold, threefold, and twofold axes of symmetry. The fivefold axes are found at the 12 vertices of the icosahedron. In the virus, VP1 is located at the fivefold axes of the particle. The threefold axes extend outward from the 20 triangular faces of the icosahedron. VP2 and VP3 alternate around the threefold axes of the virus particle. The twofold axes extend out of the center of each of the 30 edges of the icosahedron. The icosahedron and its axes of symmetry serve as convenient landmarks in describing the structure. Poliovirus assembles in infected cells. One of the early intermediates seen is a protomer consisting of one copy each of VP1 and VP3 and one copy of a precursor protein VP0 in which VP4 and VP2 are covalently linked. The protomers assemble to form pentamers which sediment at approximately 14S. 12 pentamers can further associate to form empty capsids. It is not clear whether the viral RNA is incorporated directly into empty capsid or is encapsidated by pentamers. Next, we introduce the backbone structure of the four capsid proteins. Then, in an act that can be done experimentally only in the presence of denaturants, we separate the capsid proteins so that their structures can be compared. In the infected cell, the genome is translated in a single large open reading frame, yielding a large polyprotein. The polyprotein is subsequently processed by viral proteases. The cleavage of the capsid precursor P1 is linked to early events in assembly. The final cleavage of VP0 does not occur until very late in assembly and may be associated with the encapsidation of the viral RNA. A comparison of the capsid proteins VP1, 2, and 3 shows that they are very similar. Indeed, the three proteins share a common core, which surprisingly is also seen in several plant virus coat proteins. The similarity of the core structures can be seen in the pairwise overlays. The cores consist of an 8-stranded antiparallel beta barrel with flanking helices, which is shown schematically in the diagram at the lower right. In contrast to the similarity of the cores, the capsid proteins have dissimilar, rather long extensions at their amino termini, and dissimilar connecting loops connecting the strands of the core. the description of the capsid proteins in terms of cores, amino terminal extensions, and connecting loops is also relevant to a description of their organization in the virus. In the virus, the cores form a closed shell, with VP1 pointing toward the five-fold axes and VP2 and VP3 pointing toward the three-fold axes. The tilts of the protein subunits result from prominent bulges of the shell at the five-fold and the three-fold axes, with a broad circular moat around the five-fold axes. Several plant viruses have a remarkably similar packing of the cores of their capsid proteins on the virus surface. The amino terminal extensions of the capsid proteins form an internal network. One particularly striking feature of this network is a structure formed by the amino terminus of VP3 at the five-fold axes, forming a twisted tube with parallel beta interactions. An analogous structure is seen at the three-fold axes of the plant viruses. We believe that the goal of this network is to direct and stabilize the formation of the pentameric assembly intermediate. The connecting loops of the protein shells adorn the outer surface of the virion, accentuating the protrusions at the five and the three-fold axes. The antigenic sites of the virus have been identified by characterizing mutants resistant to neutralization by monoclonal antibodies. We have grouped these mutations into three clusters. The first cluster of mutations is contained predominantly within a single loop connecting the top strands to the beta barrel of VP1. The sites cluster near the five-fold axes of the particle. Site 1 dominates the neutralizing response to type 2 and type 3 poliovirus in mice. The second cluster of mutations includes residues from a large loop in VP1, a large loop in VP2, and residues at the carboxy terminus of VP2. These mutations cluster near the two-fold axes of the virion. The third cluster of mutations includes residues from a loop near the carboxy terminus of VP1, from the small insertion top loop of VP3, and a residue from the top loop of VP2. These mutation sites cluster near the three-fold axes of the virion. Sites 2 and 3, shown together here, dominate the neutralizing response to type 1 poliovirus in mice. When one considers all of the antigenic sites of poliovirus, it is apparent that they define ridges on the virus particle, and that these ridges outline deep valleys on the outer surface. These deep valleys, which are inaccessible to antibodies and therefore not subject to immune selection, are attractive candidates for the site responsible for the recognition by the cellular receptor for poliovirus. X-ray crystallographic studies of poliovirus have produced a detailed description of the architecture of the particle, showing a surprising similarity with several previously studied plant viruses and providing a three-dimensional framework for interpreting several of the biological properties of the virus. Perhaps more important is the prospect that the structure will furnish a framework for both the design and interpretation of future experiments, including genetic manipulations of the virus. Such experiments will generate further insights into the relationship between virus structure and function, and in the long term may provide a basis for the rational design of improved vaccines and antiviral drugs for polio and related viruses.